What's up, everybody? We are back on Elm Creek, a $6 million farm. Today we've got some work to do. We got the soybeans harvested after last episode. We just ran out of time to get it all done in one video. So all this is done. We're gonna do some mulching on this. We're not gonna be able to plant anything in it. If we take a look here, you can see nothing's available to plant all the way up till March. But we're probably gonna hold off on this one and plant some corn in it. But we're gonna mulch it up. We're gonna sell our cultivator because we just got a better mod for doing this stuff. We got this 9 meter plow. It goes 10 miles an hour and it actually does plowing. So we can even buy two of these to do what we need to do. So let's go to the garage here. We're gonna get rid of this cultivator. It's gonna give us 91,000. So we're going to be back over 200,000. We're slowly getting this farm put together the way we want it. And we do have our seeder now, and we have a planter. We have rollers, but we need a mulcher. And I want to get a worker on this so we can get another fertilizer spreading on the other field. So we're going to get something that the worker can use. I have a mod, these two here on the end, but for some reason it won't work with the worker. So the best thing we can do, that's 6 meters, that's 5.8, 5.6. So, I mean, all of these, the best one's going to be 6 meters. So, it's going to take some time. But we're going to go ahead and buy this. I still don't know why the bells are in there. So, if anybody knows, leave it in the comments below, please. It would help me out a bunch. But we're going to run back over here to the shop, grab a tractor, get it hooked up to this. Once we get him started, first thing we're going to do is go check on the chickens. Get an idea of what they got going on. The day is probably going to be finished off with the mulching. It's November 1st, but it's 1:40 in the afternoon. So worker's going to get to work on the mulching. See, we got the 8R in here. We're going to want this one for fertilizing, so we need the 7R. Let's go over here and open these doors. Really liking how the farm's set up, by the way. Oh, that one's set up for fertilizing too. So we can just use the other one. I'm guessing it sent that mulcher to the shop, so we're probably gonna have to reset it and get them to deliver it for us. I didn't think it was gonna do that every time. So we got everything down there. Where the shop's right here, I thought. See if we can get rid of these icons and see what we can see. Yeah, that's a roller. The mulcher's not here. Did it spawn off the map? It's gonna suck if it glitched it for us. So, yeah, we have the mulcher. Show on map. Oh, it's all the way up there. So we can reset that. I mean, it's right on the field where we need it, but just for ease of use, we'll go ahead and grab this 8R here. Get it pulled out of here. And we'll see you guys when we get over to the field. All right, we got the worker all set up. We're gonna get ready to go check on the chickens, but I did a headland pass all the way around. You can see how slow he's going, but he's going to mulch this whole field. You can barely tell the difference. But we're going to mulch it, and then we're going to plow it all up. But we might not get to that just in this episode. So let's just go ahead and hop across on over to the farm. And I think what we're going to do, since we have a little spare cash, we're going to need some way to haul these chicken eggs. So let's go in here. I've got a nice little. What is this? Oh, yeah, that's a. We don't need that. We don't need that. Don't need that. I guess it's just in trucks. So we've got the Dodge Ram in gas or in diesel. So, right now it only has 200 horsepower, and I have yet to see a way to change that. There it is. There's a John Deere. I think we're gonna put the cap on it. That way we can put some eggs in there as well. We do want the tailgate. We don't need the salter attacher. We need the gooseneck plus adjustable. If I could see it, would be nice. That's an adjustable hitch. We don't need. We just need the gooseneck plus 2-inch. We don't want it white. Patriot blue. It looks like crap with the stickers, so let's go with a little lighter of a color. That doesn't look too shabby at all. But like I said, I still don't see a way to change the horsepower. Plow mount or no plow mount. Fog lights. We'll take them. Fender flares. Take the black ones. Mirrors up or down. Does nothing. Steps did nothing. Decals did nothing. I'm really not seeing how to adjust the horsepower. So we're just going to be stuck with 200 horsepower, I guess. So let's go with that. And then let's go get one of the little trailers. I think it's in, yeah, miscellaneous. We just want a trailer like that. Yep, that'll work. This should be delivered to us in the yard. Yep, there it is. So let's go ahead and pull this thing on up, hook it up to the trailer, and go check on the chickens. Now, I'm not too sure if we're even going to have eggs yet, but we needed a way to be able to transport them back and forth. Now, there is a flat deck semi-trailer, but I think that's a little overkill at the moment. We're going to be selling these things as soon as we get good prices. I need to be watching the prices. Yeah, we've already got a pallet and a half of eggs. So, we're good there. Let's just take this truck on back to the house and park it up. And then we're going to grab the tractor with the fertilizer spreader on it and go fertilize our wheat field. Get ready for that. And then should be good to go. I might end up buying another fertilizer or another mulcher, and I'll start working on the other side with the tractor. That way it's not too slow. So we're just gonna whip this bad boy right on around and park it up by the shed. Oh, we don't need our blinker on anymore. Yeah, we'll just park that about right there, and then we'll be good to go. And if we do get to the point where we're making too many eggs, we can always put the eggs on the trailer, transport them over to here, and put them in this shed for storage until we have a semi-trailer load. We're going to run over here and feed the puppers real quick. Okay, bowl's full. She should come running. So let's hop in the other tractor, head over to our wheat field, see if we can get it fertilized, and go from there. Hopefully we can get a good bit done today in this episode. It's kind of hard to tell how long they're going to be when I'm recording them, because I edit a bunch of stuff out and I record them all in one session. So sometimes they're too long, sometimes they're too short. But we'll see you guys over at the field. Well, I guess we're not doing that then. So at the moment, it's not ready to fertilize again. So we're going to have to wait for another stage. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go park this thing up, the fertilizer spreader, buy another mulcher, and then crack on with helping this guy mulch. So we'll throw in a little time lapse for you guys here, and we'll come back to you when we get this done. Well, I think I've come to the executive decision that we won't be doing this anymore. I'm gonna sell these right off the bat. I'm gonna let the worker keep going. We are actually gonna go take our load of eggs down to the sell point, and we're gonna sell these things right back, because that is a waste of time. I mean, it just takes way too long for the big fields that we have. Now, maybe the store will get something eventually that is bigger and we can actually get the job done in a decent manner. But I mean, for Pete's sake, that was like 25 minutes or 20 minutes and we didn't even get half the field done. So let's go ahead and park this tractor back up and we'll get ready to, we're going to put the fertilizer spreader back on it, because we will be doing that probably tomorrow. If our wheat grows a little bit, we can hit it with another dose of fertilizer. So let's go ahead and get this hooked up. I'm going to park this back in this shed and we'll wash this tractor after we get done fertilizing, but right now it's kind of pointless, because in a day or so we're just going to be pulling this thing back out and getting her dirty again. So at some point, hopefully, we'll be able to cut our grass again. It's almost there. It's got like one more growth stage, but I hope it grows in time for us to be able to get it before winter hits, because can't make silage in the snow. But you can see here the patch we missed. That's full grown, and then you can see here this patch is a little shorter. So we're just going to give it some time. If it's not ready in a day or so, by the 1st of December, we're going to go ahead and just cut it all. I mean, it's better than getting no silage. So let's pull over here. Let's get these eggs loaded. They're not very heavy, so we should be able to pick them up by hand, stack them in the trailer. Technically, with this truck, we probably don't even need the trailer. We could just put them in the bed cover. But let's pull up here. Let's put our flashers on so nobody hits us. I'm just going to go ahead and sell them all. Apparently, we can't pick them up, but I got a thing for that. I'm going to go ahead and stack them in here. We'll get that half pallet as well, just to take it. I mean, there's no point in leaving it here. We're at the best price of the year, so might as well just get them all sold. And once we get these sold, we need to come back and check how the chickens are doing for food. Love how that straps on there and squishes my eggs. Sorry, car. Trying to get to my eggs, man. Had my flashers on. So let's pull right on in here. We'll load these two pallets up. And I think these are going to be a decent little money earner for us. If we were on easy, the egg prices would be like $5,000 per 1,000 liters. Or however they do it. I don't know how they price the eggs, but everything else is per 1,000 liters. So go ahead and strap that down, strap that down. Got all the straps on that. I've already got it tagged on the map where we need to go. Just go ahead and go through here. It's just grass. It ain't gonna hurt nothing. We'll head on up here and see what we can get for eggs. We'll see you when we get there. Hey, puppers, get out of the road. Dang dog, trying to get run over. So we have 4,267 liters. I would have just jump cut to when we got to the store, but the dog was in the middle of the road, so we'll see you there. Well, we're here. We're pulling up to the egg sale point, the farmer's market up here. Sold some stuff here before, but we're gonna pull right on in here, get the trailer over the sale point, see what we can get done. Eggs is not accepted here. How do you figure? Oh, it's over there. I see. I pulled in the wrong side. Let's say it told me it took eggs here. Let's pull up right into here. Should be alright. Yep, selling away. See what we get for 4,067 liters. Oh, $6,000? That's not too bad. That'll help us out a lot through the winter, being slow and whatnot. Give us something to do and something to sell. We'll have to feed the chickens and haul their eggs. But once we get to winter, if you guys are kind of wondering what we're going to do for that, we'll probably do multiple days in an episode just to keep things interesting and not to just have a 3-minute episode of us hauling eggs. So that's going to be the plan going forward. But I think we're kind of hitting our limit on time, because most of this video has actually been us talking instead of us just time-lapse and stuff. So we're going to go ahead and call it there, guys. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please hit that like button. Subscribe to the channel if you're new around here. Helps us out a bunch. Let's grow our community here and make it a place everybody wants to be. But we'll see you guys in the next one.